Welcome back to Homesick. We've just left the nightmare world, and I think what we accomplished there is opening up whatever's down here. I'm not actually sure if I can go down the hallway. It's gonna be too bright. I've gotta go this way. But there was a locked door over this way, and it should now be open. Wait, I think it's the other way, isn't it? Yeah, it's not this way. It is this way. Let's make sure the light switch is on. Leave it on. Yeah, here we go. Ah, it's a gymnasium. That music combined with these environments is just so, so good. Okay, I'm definitely going to be doing something with all of these, radiators, I guess they are? Heaters? I'm guessing that's going to be more relevant for the nightmare world, though. I think that's the way I have to go, because I'm guessing these are probably locked. It's just looped around. God, that music. Thank you. not really sure where I'm supposed to go at this point. Oh, I can't forget to check behind the door. I'm pretty sure this is gonna do nothing in this world. Each one only has two positions. I'm going to assume that going clockwise opens them, and let's try opening every single one. I might be getting ahead of myself here. I'm still gonna do it anyway, though. It just feels good. Watch, I'm probably gonna be closing every single one rather than opening them. Okay, what now? I don't see any plants around here to water. Can I go back into the nightmare world right now? And go see what's going on there? Poke it! Ah, I can't anymore. Yeah, I mean, do I just go to sleep? I don't think I can. Like, I'm pretty sure you have to grow some flowers every single time before you can go back to sleep. But, let's try it. Yeah, I can't even go back down on the couch. Maybe one of the chairs in the gymnasium I could have sat in, and I didn't see it. Just to double check, these are locked, right? I'm gonna pay hyper attention to every single detail. I don't want to miss another sign or something like that. I don't want to repeat. Also, I'm clipping through this wood. Yep, so those doors back there are definitely locked. This one is also definitely locked, or jammed or something. I can mess around with the radiator things, but it doesn't seem to serve a purpose yet. Yeah, can I rest in one of these chairs? Apparently not. Oh, wait. Here we go? Here we go. He's not tired yet, is he? No, so he won't enter the nightmare realm until I've done my thing for the day. Which, in the past 2 days, has been growing the plants, but I haven't actually found any plants to grow, let alone water to feed them with. So he won't go to sleep. Well, in that case, I have no freaking clue what to do. None at all. I don't know why I just messed with those. I probably just made it worse. I really didn't want to be stuck in this game again, but I think I am. It's gotta be in here, right? I mean, this is the only thing I've opened up. This area. I haven't gained any new tools. The only new thing is this area. Oh, you can kind of see through the cracks. That looks like a piano, I think. I think it's a piano. Alright, one more quick pass through and then I am going to cut. I guess it's got to be something with the valves? I guess? But they don't make any noise or anything. There's no way to tell anything's even happening. What about these doors? Do these doors shut? Is there something maybe behind them? It won't close. I am once again stuck. Alright, well, I'm gonna cut here and I'll be right back. Whoa. What? What did I do? Huh? I literally just turned the valve, like, randomly, just because I was bored. I don't even know what I did. Did I do these in a secret combination? What? God, that is the worst feeling when you solve a puzzle without actually solving it and without knowing what you did or why. Okay. I did a thing. Alrighty then. I guess we can go to sleep now. I don't get it. I don't get what you're supposed to do there. Mm. That nightmare sequence was pleasantly much, much shorter than the last one. It is a piano. Twenty-seven could be important. Well, there's page numbers at the bottom of it. 1213, 1214, 1215. Probably not important, though. Yeah, I mean, they all have page numbers. I doubt it means anything. The game's music just stopped. That's eerie. And you can actually play the piano, every single key. It's horribly out of tune. I could have a lot of fun with that. And the game's music starts back up. That's so cool. Oh, look at the wood on the piano. It just looks amazing. Ooh. Hello. I took a music theory class once, like a year ago, and I don't remember any of it. In other words, I can play this perfectly. I'm guessing the grouping of three means that that's supposed to be triplets. So 1-2-3-1, 1-2-3-1-2, 1-2-3-1-2? Or something like that, I think. I don't remember what the symbols mean exactly, but I think that's a triplet, and then a fourth note, and then a fourth note, and then a hold. Or sustain. Not sure what the right terms are. Ooh, hello. God, I love it when you look at something in a game like this and it looks good from here. And then you get really, really, really close to it like this. Like, you just stick your nose in it and it still looks amazing. Sure would be helpful if I could read that. Right, so what is this powering? It's powering that nub on this side of the wall? I don't get it. Oh. Oh, did I just loop around? This is back to the starting room, right? No, wait. I haven't been here before. Is this a completely different room, or just the same room that's changed? No, this is completely different. Where am I? This is very similar to the very starting area, but it's not the same. There was a door here in the starting area, but it was locked, and what was here was an axe. Same general shape, but a little bit different. I want to see the rest of this place before I actually explore any of the rooms, because I want to know if this is the same place or what. I'm getting kind of creeped out here. This is similar, if not the same. Alright, let's try the remaining passwords on this. I still have two unused. We have 000. Great. All the way around again. You know what, screw it. Since I've already messed that up, let's try 8294. Nope. Alright, 000. Let's try the one that never, ever, ever worked. 7461. That was in the newspaper. Bah. I can look at it, but I can't take it. Alright, this place is getting kind of big, so I'm going to go back here and explore that first one that I found. The first room. Let's make sure there's nothing behind the door. Okay, so this tells me what each symbol kinda means. Or at least some of them. That one means car, I guess? Bee, apple, dog, flower. This looks like a house that's flooding, and I saw some pictures of a flooded area. That looks like some sort of an oil well thing, and I think I saw an old picture of, like, a burning oil well fire. So it seems to echo what I've seen in the pictures. That's a freaking tornado. This one means B, right? Dot and then a circle? Yeah. Sure why they're flashing when I pick up those blocks. Why is it blinking? Oh, that's the other half of the picture. I'm guessing the tear is not only for the paper, but kind of representative of something that happened. It's not time to sleep yet. I have a flower that I need to grow. Hello, my poor dead friend. I'll bring it to life soon enough. Don't fret. I feel like I should be picking up those blocks, but I can't seem to. Weird. Oh, now here we're back. Yeah, now we've actually looped around. That was the fire axe. Mm-hmm. Make sure there's something behind the door. Oh, right. That was there before. Industrial stuff. Looks like logging. Wait, Wait, is that logging or is that like a forest fire or something? Those are some creepy looking masks. Are they gas masks? I thought gas masks looked different. I don't see a filter. Okay, well that's everything. So once again, I have no idea what to do. I know I need to bring that single solitary flower back to life, so I need water. That much is obvious. I've looped fully around. I wonder if I need to open that filing cabinet. But what could the password be? I tried the only two passwords that I actually had left, and none of those worked, and I tried the extra one that seemed like it might be a password. That was in the newspaper a long time ago, that didn't work. I don't have anything else. Right at the end of this, it almost looks like it says 10-10, but I don't think that's what that is. Because there's the same thing in a bunch of other different places. It's gotta be some sort of translation-y thing with the blocks, right? It's gotta be something about the blocks. But what? What do I do with the blocks? I have a key for some of the blocks in here. Tells me what some of them represent. But I don't see how that helps me. Yeah, I really don't see how that helps me. Oh, hey. I didn't know this opened. Ooh. Okay, that seems pretty important. I think this might be the key I needed. Also, I kind of totally forgot about the piano and the piece of sheet music that I picked up. Let's go play piano. You know, I don't think I've ever played a good... I don't think I've ever experienced a good musical puzzle in a game ever. In theory, I would love a musical puzzle, but I don't think I've ever actually played a good one. Not that I can think of off the top of my head. Hey, bring it back up. What are you doing? Alright, I'm guessing if you could actually read music, maybe this is the only thing you would need to be able to play it. but I can't really. I have no idea what notes those are. In fact, how am I supposed to know where this is? Well, I guess it's a sure bet that the dead notes probably aren't included, so I guess it's gotta be around here. Let's see. Let's count the black keys. Two black, three, two, three, two. Oh, it alternates? Okay. Two, three, two, three. Are these valid? No, so I'm guessing the two on this note, the two black keys, is probably these two. I can use the mouse for this, because I need to use precise aiming. So if that is the right one, then... three blue... Blue is just the left of these two, so it's... okay, that's a dead note. Probably not that one, then. Let's assume it's this one. That sounds right. Okay. So... then green, which is in between the neck... these two. Right? Mm-hmm. I'm playing this so slowly, it doesn't even sound like music. One wrong note, and everything comes crashing down. It's also really inconvenient that this piece of paper is covering up my crosshair. I wish it was like an inch to the right. Very annoying. Very, very, very annoying. Alright, that was the red note. Back to the blue. Yellow. Purple. Was that there before? I swear that just appeared, but maybe that's just my imagination? Did I do it? I mean, what would that do if it worked? Make the plant grow? Let's go find out. I feel like I did that right. Nope. Poor plant, he's still dead. Okay, I'm gonna mess around with that some more. And I'll be right back. Okay, welcome back. Let me get to something in a second. Before I get to the thing, let me just say, I did find a nice way to solve the annoyance of holding the paper in front of my crosshair, making it hard to play, which is that you can just set them down here, which is very logical, since that's where music sheets tend to go. Yeah, I probably should have thought of that. So at least I can play without them being in my way anymore. The thing is, though, I played the piano, and I played it correctly like four different times, and it doesn't seem to do anything, from what I can tell, so I don't know, I don't get it. I'm like 99% sure I'm playing it correctly, and I've done it multiple times, and I've done it relatively fast as well. So I'm not sure what's up with that. Maybe I did do it correctly and it did something and I just didn't see or something. I don't know. Also, I kind of forgot about these. Unfortunately, though, I don't really know what they're for and they don't seem to have a point yet. I mean, they go over here to this nub. And then I'm guessing they're used either for the elevator's power or perhaps for the lights. Don't know. The symbols on them are, they're actually, all of these symbols are represented back in that room, the child's room. In fact, I actually wrote them down. So this circle, there's a picture of that in the child's room, that circle, and it has a picture of an apple. And then this one here has the picture of the bee. So all of these are represented in the child's room, but that doesn't actually help me do anything with them. So I don't really get it. But here's the thing. So I spent like 20 minutes, or hell, maybe even more. I guess about 30 minutes at this point, just wandering around, plinking on the piano and trying to find anything I missed. I mean, I know I'm supposed to play something on the piano, but I feel like I've already done it. I know there's something with the blocks, but I wasn't sure what to do with the blocks. The blocks are obviously related to the control panel, the power panel over here, but I wasn't sure how exactly or what this power panel actually powered. So, like, I get the stuff I'm supposed to be working on, I just don't know what I'm supposed to do with it. However, I looked up a walkthrough online, or rather, not really a walkthrough so much as kind of just a hint guide sort of thing. For the most part, it doesn't give you the solutions, it just gives you hints. And I found something out about these blocks. So you know how I picked them up and I felt like I should have been able to, you know, do something with them? And I was wondering why they're blinking? Guess what? You're supposed to translate the symbols into symbols you can actually read. Symbols that you type on the keyboard. You might ask, why didn't I think of this? Well, the reason is because I'm, you know. It's because I'm using a controller. I'm using a controller. I can't type on a controller. Literally, none of the buttons, not even the D-pad, cycles through the characters on the keyboard. Literally, none of the buttons on my controller are capable of causing letters to appear on the block. So this game supports the controller, except not really, because you literally cannot use the controller to complete the game. So, thanks for informing me of this fact, game. That is a wonderful user experience. The block is blinking because I'm supposed to type, except you didn't tell me I'm supposed to type, and oh, I guess I'm not supposed to use a controller, except you can use a controller. Except when you can't. What the f... Like, this... Oh my god, I'm so fucking annoyed. Ah! I was hoping this episode I'd be less annoyed with this game than I was in the previous episode, but man, I'm even more annoyed now. That is such a terrible experience. What were they thinking? Why would you do that? If you want me to type, just say, type a letter. Tell me that that's what you want me to be able to do. The fact that it's flashing doesn't tell me I'm supposed to be able to type. And if you didn't want this game to be playable on a controller, why didn't you tell me so? Would have been kind of helpful. Alright. I guess I'm just gonna switch to the keyboard and mouse. We'll see how this goes. I don't even know the controls. I know it's C for crouch, WASD to move, left click to use, scroll wheel to cycle through items. Alright, I guess I'll just use the mouse. Alright, so now this is making more sense. So what this isn't about this symbol represents apple or this symbol represents red. This is the circle represents A for apple. So I'm supposed to find a block of that type, I'm guessing, and replace it with A, and then that'll automatically translate everything else. That is my guess. Alright, so this L means car, so that's C. I'm guessing. And this is... let's find one more. God, even the mouse controls are terrible. Look at it. You move slowly and it's nice and smooth, but if you move really fast... It's like this weird jerking motion thing. I don't know, it doesn't seem to be doing it now, but it was a second ago. Calm down. I'm sure the game will get better from here. Alright, A is for apple. A is for apple. Okay, there we go. I was kind of close to wanting to quit this game forever, but having to do these translations was actually, believe it or not, kind of fun. I had to keep going between newspaper articles and books and stuff like that and trying to, you know, trying to figure out more and more words until they started to make more sense and, you know, it was really slow going at first because most words I couldn't make out, but now I've translated almost every single block and almost everything is readable. It was actually surprisingly fun. The tedious thing is that I had to go between the blocks and, you know, very slowly walking back to some sort of a note to read to try to figure out more letters. So going back and forth was tedious, but other than that, that was actually pretty interesting. So let's read some stuff now. Oh, I also noticed the note that is on here actually gives you the password. Spare keys, and here the combination is 3311. Yes, that's one of the things that hasn't been translated yet, that the vertical line, that's actually an N, so that's why it says 3311. I think there was, one door I can remember that had a rusty lock. I guess any of these might work as well. Oh, there we go. I'm hoping there's more blocks in here. It's really hard to tell, but that's a picture of a dog. There's a lot of pictures of dogs for some reason. Yeah, so almost all of these are readable. I want to completely translate everything before I start reading, though. Because it's going to trip me up, having the occasional letter that just doesn't belong. It's readable, but I can't quite smoothly read it. God, look at that chair. Look at that chair. It looks freaking real. I'm guessing this might be important, though. Nope, don't think so. Yeah, I'm going to come back and probably read all these notes once I've fully translated everything. I guess this was just a bonus area because it doesn't seem like you actually have to come in here. Let's see if I can unlock some other doors. Yeah, so I think that's all the story stuff. Which I want to read, but not quite yet. Although I get the feeling I might be at the end of the game. So maybe I should read it. Ooh, hello. Ooh, this one I haven't done. Do I have this written down? Yes, I do. That's actually a cue. Yeah, there's like one or two blocks that I haven't translated. I think N is the biggest one that I haven't done. I just don't know where the darn thing is. Let me take one quick look in here. Oh, this one hasn't been done either. I can't ever remember actually seeing this, so I'm going to assume it's something that's used really uncommonly. Which, well, I've already done Z. What would it be? Maybe X? Do you notice something weird? Look on the bottom left of the screen. One of the other cubes, every time I change the letter on this cube, the cube in the bottom left wiggles back and forth. What the heck? Okay, that's kind of weird. Alright, I'm just going to assume that's an X, and... Oh, wait. Oh, there's the one for N, so that's supposed to be an N. Actually, I think that might be everything. Yeah, let's see. No! There's a D that needs to be translated into a G. Yeah. So the G is not right. Alright. Well, I want to sleep. I want to save the game. Because if I quit the game right now, I think all my translation work is going to be for naught. Barely got any in the pot, but good enough, I guess. During the nightmare sequence, the mouse smoothing is kind of gone. Chop up the piano! I'm just kidding, that thing's beautiful. It might be that there's still stuff I need to do in the normal world to actually be able to do what I need to do here. That would not surprise me. Yeah, I feel like that's the case. So, hold on. Let's get up. I might need to do something with the elevators. Because the directions are actually going to make sense now. So we should be able to do whatever the heck needs to be done with the power panel. Oh wait, I converted something wrong. Just, the X should be a J. Let's go do that before I forget. Where was it? Much better. Follow these carefully or the elevator will not work. I don't know why, it's just really bad wiring, I guess, but I found this is what works. First, make sure all the breakers are off. Then, in this order... Okay, hold on. Make sure they're all off. What's the off position? Left? Let's assume that's the case. Okay. C, A, B, then C off. C, A, B, C, E. C, A, B, C, E. Nope. Alright, so I guess this is the opposition. C, A, B, C, E. Did I fuck that up to begin with? C, A, B, C, E. Huh? Oh, I didn't even read the bottom of the note. Left is on, right is off. But I just tried it both ways, so... shouldn't it have worked? C, A, B, C, E. Is it just silent? Okay. Do I have to wait for the nightmare world? Or something? I'm gonna go to sleep now and see if it works now. That way it was blocked off before, maybe now it's not. I think decrypting the blocks and kind of decrypting that weird symbolic language, or whatever you want to call it, was the only puzzle in this game that's actually... yeah, here we go. I think that was the only puzzle that actually felt like a puzzle. Like, I actually thought, oh, this makes sense, I get what I'm supposed to be doing, and I can actually do this. The rest of these are like, I guess this is doing something, maybe, kinda, I hope? Bye! Alright, so now the elevator's open. I feel like that might be the end of the game when I walk into the elevator. If it is, then I don't want to go there until I've finished reading everything. Oh my god. Please don't go down. Oh. Oh! No, there's more! Jesus, this architecture is beautiful. Oh. Would now be a good time to go read those notes? One second, I'll be right back. Okay, I'm back. Yeah, I think I'm gonna go back upstairs. I probably am. Let's just take a quick look down here and just kind of see how big this place is. So I really do feel like this might be the end of the game. I feel like I just walk out the front door, because this looks like the front door. Plans for more housing company unveiled. I don't want to read everything fully just yet. All the residents. I have a feeling, based on the massive size of this list, that these are Kickstarter backers. Because there's something about this list that seems very unnatural. I wonder if I'm on it. I was a Kickstarter backer, but I wasn't a very high tier. And I feel like if... Yeah, if it was a pretty low tier that made it onto this list, and I think this list would be a lot longer, so I'm probably not here. Also, am I crazy, or is this not alphabetically sorted? This isn't alphabetically sorted, is it? These aren't the right keys. Yeah, does this open? It is the outside world. The schedule for evacuation drills has been increased. No, it doesn't open, so I'm not quite done yet. Yeah, this isn't the very end of the game just yet. I think I need one more nightmare sequence to open the front doors. And then I have a feeling that'll be it. Hmm. I can just get the water from here, right? My bucket not full. Oh, the water isn't high enough, is it? I mean, you could still get water from there, though. Just put it in the bottom. Okay, whatever. So I guess you're supposed to increase the water level in the fountain? I was gonna say the thing because I didn't remember the name of it. That's called a fountain. The more you know. But one thing I'm still wondering is, what's the point of the piano? Maybe I did actually complete it, but I don't know what it did. And if I haven't completed it, then what is doing it do? I don't get the point of it. And I have no idea what to do to fill up that thing. How would I fill up the fountain? So I need the key to get inside of that door. I have keys, but I don't have the right key. I believe there was actually like a rusted... Yeah, let's explore a little bit more before I end the episode. I think there was a rusted door somewhere back here. Yeah, it was in the gymnasium, right? Maybe this key works. Assuming the lock isn't so rusted over that I can't use it. God, that is beautiful. Yeah, this one. I think it's too rusted over. I think it's just jammed shut. Yeah. Are there any other locked doors? Not that I remember off the top of my head, but maybe. Alright, well, I think I'm gonna call it there. Yeah, I'm gonna call it there. So, next episode, I think what I'm gonna do is probably just comb over the entire place and read all the notes. It's probably gonna take a long time, because there's a lot of notes I've passed over. But now that I've translated everything, I'm really curious what's going on. And I'm guessing it's gonna reveal what this game is actually about. You know, what the story is. Because so far, I know very, very little about the story. Just vague hints to industrial accidents and stuff like that. And a child and a child and a parent being broken apart somehow. You know, based on the picture. So, I'm really curious. And I suppose in the next episode, we'll find some answers to our questions. So, I hope you've enjoyed so far, and I'll be back soon.